Come on. Brian Reagan's going to push the nose forward, and the altimeters will wind down, and the airspeed will wind up. They'll reach subsonic speeds in excess of 150 miles an hour. Brian pulls back on the stick. You can tell these airplanes are open cockpit biplanes. That means there's no roof over the pilot's head. And I'll tell you what, folks, for the history of flight and the mystery of flight, that that's the king of the air. As the Red Barons move from our left to right, they're going to reposition the right here. ATA turn. You know, there really is no other kind of flying like formation aerobatic flying. Nothing else uses a pilot's talents, a pilot's abilities, a pilot's instincts, or concentration. This kind of flying right here, while they're in the tight formation, the wingmen never ever take their eyes off of that lead airplane. Their eyes are glued to them. It is their whole world, whether it's upside down, right side up, or inside out. The wingmen never take their eyes off him. The lead airplane, in contrast to those wingmen, he never looks at the other three guys. He's looking at you because he has to fly for four. And that means he has to correct the formation for the winds that are aloft over Titusville today in order to keep these maneuvers centered and choreographed for all of our airshow fans. Once again, there they are. Inverted and upside down simultaneously and at the same time. Now they're going to move through the airshow playground from left to right, and we will see Brian Reagan. And the wing, followed by Jason Wilson, number three, Matt Losacker, and number four, Travis August, and Mick Carson. The two part of every airshow pilot's energy equation, those two parts being altitude and airspeed. You gotta trade one to get the other. Follow the leader through a series of tail chase maneuvers. Are proud to keep the airplanes where they belong, and that's up in the sky. Watch this. Over 300 miles an hour of hyposonic closure speed. Top speed on the steerman biplanes of the Red Barons is 186 miles an hour. That's when the plane starts to peel over the configuration. Steerman biplanes were built by Boeing aircraft. 1939 to 1945. World War II is a war that we won. The fact that we were victorious in World War II allows all of us to enjoy the high quality of life as citizens of the United States of America. And a big part of our victory in World War II, as Red Baron 3 and 4 victory roll out of the box. The Army Air Corps and the Navy during World War II, because the Air Force wasn't even in existence yet back then. So all the fighter pilots around the world in World War II learned to fly in these airplanes right here. Watch this maneuver. Brian and Jason go straight up together, hanging it on the peg, a double hammerhead turn. Watch Jason as he moves around the formation, being stabilized by his leader, Brian Reagan. The airplane was built in Wichita, Kansas, by Boeing aircraft. During the years of World War II, about 10,000 Stearmans rolled off the Boeing assembly line, and there's about 3,000 of them. Some of our biggest airshow fans are those gentlemen, those pilots from World War II, all these guys now in their mid to late 80s who come up to us at every airshow and say, I learned to fly in this airplane. And I mean this airplane. These are not rebuilt replicas. These are the real deals. In fact, that airplane flown by Brian Reagan rolled off the Boeing assembly line in Wichita, Kansas on December the 8th, 1941. That's right, folks. That airplane was born. Brian Reagan and Jason Wilson go straight up 20, 10, 0 miles an hour using the rudder with prop blast over the tail, turning the airplane on the vertical line for a double hammerhead turn. And bring it back in towards each other. After the years of World War II, these airplanes became the backbone of the crop dusting industry in the 1950s and the 1960s as Brian and Jason Fox wing to wing on top of the double woven loop. Jason moves out in position and run send him back into trail formation. He follows Brian's smoke around the top in a big, beautiful on the left side of the box, Brian Reagan of Phoenix, Arizona, Jason Wilson of Marshall, Minnesota, go straight up together in trail. Two hammerheads bring him roaring and thundering back in from left to right. And the noise you hear from these airplanes is not engine noise. It's actually the sound of the propeller tubes. Pilot spins and spools these props up to full RPM. The tips of the propellers go supersonic. You're hearing coming off the tips of those propellers. We have a special name for our propellers because they are supersonic. We call them propperonis. And that allows these airplanes to really speak for themselves when they're in front of you. And that makes my job pretty easy because all I got to do is say, look at that. This is their passion. This is what they love to do. The pilots wear an intricate set of seatbelts that actually make them part of the airplane. And there's an old saying amongst pilots of the Sturman biplane that when you go to fly like a Red Baron, you do not get into this airplane. You have to put it on just like you would a set of clothes. Man and machine become one. In fact, one of the pilots who loves this airplane as much as the Red Barons do is probably one of the most famous pilots who ever lived. Charles Lindbergh flew this airplane. And Charles Lindbergh once said of the Sturman biplane, "We are each a part of the other, this machine and I. Apart from me, she is cold and lifeless." First, if you like that first heart, here comes another one, and this one we're going to dedicate to Mom. Thanks for bringing the kids out today, Mom. And of course, for Jerry, he's on that Atkins thing. And that's the one that's a big hit at my house. You'll love it. Look on the left. Watch them get back in formation. None of these airplanes has a power advantage over the others, so they have to have an instinctual knowledge of all of that geometry, the vectors, the angles, the cutoffs. We're seeing a demonstration of this right here. It's the Red Baron rolling rejoin using the global angles to get back in formation. That's how you do it. Watch Travis Arden run this as he pulls it up again. Of a young German fighter pilot named Manfred von Richthofen, a man who invented new formation procedures and maneuvers every time he went aloft. Here comes one of my favorites, folks. They go straight up together, spreading out to get a little elbow room, hanging it out to dry, times four. That's the Red Baron cluster hammerhead turn. while the pilot's vision fills up with terra firma, and they use the next maneuver to tighten the formation back up. I never get tired of watching this formation. When they're in tight formation like this, they are actually overlapping wingtips inside the sweet spot. And when they insert the sweet spot, which is when the in and out forces of that wing turbulence are equalized. Now it's time to play Fat Little Leader once again through the Squirrel Cage series of moves. Is referred to as a tail dragger.
Hey, on the roll, front and left, is the steering taxi guy. We've got that camel, that soft, never seen it, woven